welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can actually open a PayPal business account here in Nigeria. You know, you can actually not you can find it easy opening a Nigerian PayPal business account in Nigeria. I don't know why. I think it's the Nigerian factor, but I don't know, there's something wrong with Nigeria. But anyways, I'm going to show you how you can actually open a PayPal business account in Nigeria with your Nigerian details on your phone. Yes, on your mobile device. You don't need a computer. So let's get right into it. If you are yet subscribed, please click on the red button below that says subscribe. Hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell beside it so that you don't miss out of any of my future videos. Thank you so much, my loyal subscribers, for always coming back for more. And if you're a new person here, please join the family by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to give this video a like, leave me a comment below, and share. Like I always say, there is love in sharing. Please share with a Nigerian friend you know that will actually need a PayPal account in Nigeria. Thank you so much, guys. Let's get right into it. So guys, I am on my mobile browser right now, and first thing you need is your email account. I'll be using a Gmail account, which I opened specifically for this. And like I said, you can actually do this on a mobile phone like I am doing right now, and you can also use it. You can follow this tutorial on a computer. And if you are not allowed to open a PayPal business account in anywhere, any part of the world, you can actually follow these steps and you'll be smiling at the end of it. So stay with me. So right now I'm going to open another tab and I'll input paypal.com. paypal.com. And naturally, because I am in Nigeria, it was supposed to bring, see this IS, when you try it, because you are in Nigeria, it will give you ng. It will be paypal.com/ng/home. But because you cannot open a business account in Nigeria, you have to change it. So I'll be changing it to IS/home. Then we go. Now I've tried this with UK, US before, but it wasn't going through. But with this IS, it went through. So the next thing for us to do is to look for the business part. So this is the business part. You click on learn more, and then it will bring you to a place where you see get started. Click on get started. Get started, and you'll be directed to provide your email address. So right now, I will be putting in the email address that I want to use. Then I press on next. Okay, so see, it will bring a form for you to fill. In order not to waste your time, I'll just explain quickly before I fill the form. Now for the forms, you see your email that you put is already there. Then you'll be required to provide password. You re-enter your password, then your first name, your last name, you put it. Your business name, you put it. Now for this country, you'll be able to change it. You'll be able to change, just click on it, and you pick Nigeria or any other country. That's, if you're watching me from another country, you pick that country. Then the code, as you can see, the code has changed. Then you'll be able to add your phone number.
So plus 2, 3, 4. That means that zero part is off. You start from 7, or 8, so. You get that. Then the business line, business address line 1, you input it. This address line 2 is optional, which I will leave. You input your city, town, and everything. You leave it at dollars because they don't accept Naira. So it can either be dollar or pounds, or you know, those internationally accepted currency. So I'll be leaving it at dollar. And mind you, you need to have a dollar card. Yes, you need to have a dollar card for this, because later on you'll be adding your MasterCard, your dollar card, to your account. And at the end, when you have filled everything, you click on agree before you continue. So let me fill all this now. The form, and the next thing is what type of business is it that you do. So you can pick anyone, if it's individual or sole proprietor. Just go through it and you'll be able to pick which type of business. So I'm going to choose individual. It's asking for the product or service. So you type in your product or service and it will bring some options for you. So you pick the one that best fits your business. Now your business URL, if applicable, is not compulsory. If you have a website for your business, you can input it. If not, just continue. Okay, so nationality. Here you'll be able to change your nationality. Like I said earlier, we use the Iceland to enter, but right now we are given the opportunity to change our nationality. So I'll be changing the nationality to Nigeria. Then identity document. So what document do you want to use? I mean, something that they can identify you with, like your passport or your driver's license or your national ID card. So I'll be picking the passport. So now they are requesting for the passport. Then date of birth. So home address is the same as business address. I clicked, it has been ticked already. But if it is not, you just untick and you'll be given opportunity to fill another one. But I'll be clicking it as the same. Then submit. Okay, so that's it. Thanks for signing up. Now the next thing for you to do is to set up your payment, and they will have automatically sent you an email for confirmation. So you just click on that email in your inbox and you will be able to confirm that this is truly your address. Now you can actually add any of these cards, your MasterCard, to your account. But for now, I won't be adding any card. You can go ahead and add. It is quite easy. Just click on continue and you know, you'll be able to add your card. But right now I want to go to my mail and see if they've actually sent me a mail for activation. Okay, so as you can see, they've sent me series of mails for activation. And this one, this first one, confirm your email. So I'm going to confirm my email. So they're asking for the password. I'll input the password. I'll input the password and then I'll confirm my email. So right now you have actually opened a PayPal business account. Congratulations. So the next thing I'm going to do right now is go into my own personal account and try and send money to this account that I have just opened, just to show you that this business account works in Nigeria, and you can actually link it to your Upwork, your Fiverr account, your Upwork account, or any other freelance, you know, anything that requires your PayPal, that requires paying in into your account, you can actually use it. So let me log in to my personal account now. So this is the account that I just opened now, and as you can see, the balance is 0.00 USD. So I'm going to transfer it to it right now. Okay guys, so this is my personal account and I am going to make a payment right now. Send payment. Okay, so it's asking for the name or email address. So I'll input the email address of the account I just opened. And pay $1 into it. Continue. So it's asking how I want to pay. I want to pay with the Master debit card and next. Okay, so this is how much I am paying. What's up? Okay, so this is like a summary of it. This is the email and the amount I want to pay. If you want to add a note, that's when you are sending. You can actually, but I'm not adding any notes. I'm the one sending to the, like I'm sending to myself, so there's no need. So $1 and send now. So you've sent $1 to adeolubi5@gmail.com. So now let me log in into the account, the business account with adeolubi5@gmail.com, and see and confirm that our money is there. I'm guessing that is actually an email from PayPal stating that adeolubi5@gmail.com has received a payment. Okay, so right now I'm trying to log in into the business PayPal account that we just opened. So I hope this tutorial has been helpful for you. Please leave me a comment below if you have any question at all. Leave me a comment. Don't forget to share with your friends, your entrepreneurs and freelancer friends. So as you can see, the account has been credited and PayPal has already deducted their own service charge, leaving this account with 65 pence. Yeah, I think I'm right, 65 pence. So that is just it. That's how you open. Let's check the notification here. Okay, so you have some to-do list like link and confirm debit card, which you should be able to do by yourself. And that's just it. See, this is the payment that I just got now, $1 from Victoria Ajaji. So that is it, guys. It's as simple as that. So when you succeed in opening yours, please tag me on social media post. I'll leave my Instagram handle below. Please let me know that this tutorial was helpful for you. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. If you're here to subscribe, please don't leave without subscribing. Please subscribe and also hit the bell beside the subscribe button so that you get notified of future videos just like this. And I also want to say that after doing all this, make sure that you go through every email that PayPal sends to your email address. You know, they might ask you to update some things like your business stuffs, so make sure you go through it and update accordingly. So thank you, guys, for watching. I hope it's helpful. Give this video a thumbs up, please, and subscribe. Bye.